What is going on, guys, and welcome to the first ever unboxing of the Thresher Ultimate wireless gaming headset for the PlayStation 4. And boy, am I super excited to show you what comes inside the box, but not only that, but show you guys how amazing they look. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get this unboxing started. All right, so let's go ahead and check out the box. What do we have in the box? We have a nice aesthetic look. It tells us a little bit of details of what we could expect out of the headset. 7.5 surround sound, 2.4 connectivity. We also have the 16 hours of lifetime within the battery charge. It takes, I believe, 4 hours to completely charge the headset to give you that nice longevity. Not only that, but it also comes with a 50 millimeter driver for the speakers. Now, those are very different from your typical headsets, which usually come with a 40. We got noise cancellation. We got one headset volume control and a cool other awesome details I want to go ahead and show you guys once we get this puppy unboxed. It comes with the headset, comes with the stand, and of course a hub and some couple wires. But let's go ahead and open this one up and see what can we expect out of the Thresher Ultimate wireless surround sound gaming headset. All right, so when we open the box, of course, all we got to do is slip up the kind of like the cover art. We will be able to open the box. We got a nice black box and we have a nice little cover that covers the box. Comes very padded, so you won't go ahead and, you know, your headset won't be moving back and forth. On the top, we got the manual, which you guys won't need, because whenever I get my hands on these, I will give you guys a complete setup tour on how to set these up with your PlayStation 4 or PC. We got an optical cable, we got some audio hubs, and we also got some power cables to power our main hub station, which is the one that's going to give us complete and total power of our headset. And it also is going to give us a nice way to actually set up our headset and put it on the rest mode in case we needed charging, because if you're like me, I like to have my desk nice and clean so we can aesthetically look correctly. So that's what the headset looks once it's taken out of the box, once it has been placed on the actual stand and underneath the hub. As you see on the top, we have the nice Razer branding on the top headband on the top side of the headset. And I want to talk to you guys a little bit about what's different and what can we expect out of the headset. We have this nice little light that also will tell us when we have connectivity with the headset and when the headset gets disconnected. It'll start blinking, letting us know the headset is no longer paired or connected to the stand, and that's a good indicator right there on the front. But overall, aesthetically, the headset looks really good. Ergonomically, it's also well shaped, fits perfectly in your head, and I like the way the ear cups are a little bit larger than usual headsets, so make sure it either covers the whole ear or keeps your ear completely padded when you're using it. Another cool thing about the headset that I did want to go ahead and mention is that we have the expandable band on the top. Not only that, but we also have the memory foam that is the pad of the bottom of the headset with a nice cooling technology. But aesthetically, you guys will notice the headset looks really, really solid. We got the 50 millimeter drivers, and we got one of my favorite things that I've, you know, out of all the headsets that I currently have or use, is the ability of being able to hide the mic and pull out the mic whenever I need it. Now, you guys saw the little red light and you're probably wondering, why is there a little red light? I'm gonna go ahead and talk a little bit about that and why that is so important when you're gaming. Now, there is an Xbox line for this headset as well. The only biggest difference between the Xbox and the PlayStation 4 is the color schematics and of course the connectivity on how you're able to connect wirelessly through the PlayStation 4 and also to the Xbox One. Now let's dive in and take a look at the memory foam pads. One of the neat features of the memory foam pad is that it gives you the ability to actually remove the cups and either use a memory foam cup with a nice clothed finish, or you can go ahead and use the one that has the leathery feel. Those are, you're able to pick up, doesn't come within the box, but you're able to actually add those if you guys so choose. So also, one neat feature about the headset that I liked was the ability of having the nice little blinking light on the mic. You're probably wondering what that is. That feature allows you and lets you know when that is blinking. It will let you know that your mic is muted. When it's not blinking or when it's not solid red, it also lets you know that your mic is active. It's a nice little feature that they added, that not only are you able to, you know, mispush the mute button, but now you visually could see if the mic is muted or if the mic is not. I thought it was a very good addition that they added to the headset, and it's very easy to turn off and on. All you do is press the, you know, the volume rocker button. You press it inwards. That will go ahead and mute your mic. Once you want to go ahead and make the mic go unmuted, You either press the button or just move the reel up and down, and it will automatically unmute the mic, which is really, really cool. Now, we take a nice look at the bass. Like I said, one of the neat features on the bass is the ability of being able to know when your headset is paired and when it's not paired. If it's not paired, it'll start blinking. If it's paired, it has a solid light. We have a optical in and we have an optical out. We also have a PC and PlayStation 4 mode in case you want to plug it to your PC and PlayStation 4. We have a USB charge port, and we have a micro USB charge port, so you could either charge it via USB, or you could also charge it by just being connected to a wall outlet or to your PlayStation 4, or, you know, your Xbox if you get the Xbox One version. Now, I would love to do a review for these headsets for you guys and let you guys know if these are actually worth picking up, if you maybe should skip them, or if you should maybe look for a different pair of headsets if you're trying to upgrade for when the new Xbox comes out, or for the PlayStation Pro, or if you're just trying to upgrade the current headset you have. Unfortunately, fellas, I wasn't provided with a review set for these headsets. I hope they actually send one out so I could give you guys an extensive review, letting you know if they're actually 16 hours, if they lasted long, if the battery charges that quickly, or how functional they are for the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox One. Of course, I would want to test each and every one individually because there's different sort of wireless technology on how you pair these and see how well they are, if there's any latency or of that sort, to give you guys the most informative review as possible. Let me know in the comment section down below if you guys would like to see a review of these headsets and if you guys are considering to pick these up. Also, if you find these videos helpful and informative, you guys could do me the huge favor of sharing this with your friends because it does help out a lot. Don't forget to drop a like and subscribe if you guys haven't subscribed to the channel. And if you want to stay up to date to all the latest gaming gadgets or gaming news, either follow me via Twitter at GFLaserBolt or follow me via Twitch, which I'll leave the link down below in the description. And don't forget, guys, for all things gaming related, make sure you keep it locked on this channel, and I will catch you guys on the next video.